Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Tulisakram Krishna Madhava. Jai Radha Madhava.
Jai Radha Madhava.
पंचतत्व की जय, श्री प्रभुपाद की जय, निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरे कृष्ण। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय,
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 ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण।
भगवद गीता एज इट इज चैप्टर 17 टेक्स्ट नंबर 13। त्रिविगुणे महे भावे,
त्रिविगुणे भावे,
एभि सर्वं इदं जगत्,
एभि सर्वं इदं जगत्,
मोहितं न विजानाति,
मोहितं न विजानाति,
मामेभ्य परम अव्ययम्,
मामेभ्य परम अव्ययम्,
त्रिविगुणमये भावे,
त्रिविगुणमये भावे,
एभि सर्वं इदं जगत्,
एभि सर्वं इदं जगत्,
मोहितं
नाभि जानाति,
मामेभ्य परम अव्ययम्,
मामेभ्य परम अव्ययम्,
त्रिविगुणमये भावे,
एभि सर्वं इदं जगत्,
मोहितं
नाभि जानाति,
मामेभ्य परम अव्ययम्,
मामेभ्य परम अव्ययम्।
Anybody wants to try? This verse is very simple, not too hard.
and a particular type of psychological and biological activities accordingly. There are four classes of man functioning in the three material modes of nature. Those who are purely in the mode of goodness are called brahmanas. Those who are purely in the mood of patience are called kshatriya. Those who are in the mode of both patience and ignorance are called vaishya. Those who are completely in ignorance are called sudras. And those who are less than that are animals or animal life. However, these designations are not permanent. I am either a brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, whatever. In any case, this life is temporary. But although life is temporary and we do not know what we are going to be in the next life, by the spell of this illusory energy, we consider ourselves in terms of this bodily conception of life. And we thus think that we are American, Indian, Russian, or Brahmana, Hindu, Muslim, etc. And if we become entangled with the modes of material nature, then we forgot the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is behind all these modes. So Lord Krishna says that living entities deluded by these three modes of nature do not understand that behind the material background is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There are many different kinds of living entities, human beings, living gods, animals, etc. And each and every one of them is under the influence of material nature. And all of them have forgotten the transcendent personality of Godhead. Those who are in the modes of passion and ignorance, and even those who are in the mode of goodness, cannot go beyond the impersonal brahmana conception of the absolute truth. They are bewildered before the Supreme Lord in his personal future, which possesses all beauty, opulence, knowledge, change, fame, and initiation. When even those who are in goodness cannot understand that what hope is there for those in passion and ignorance. Krishna consciousness is transcendental to all these three modes of material nature, and those who are truly established in Krishna consciousness are actually liberated. Om Jnana Tiranadasya Jnanam Jinam Silapaya Chakshuru Nimitam Vem Sitasme Shri Guru Tenam Shri Chaitanya Manovisam Sthapita Mena Bhutale Shvarupa Kadamayam Dadati Svarantikam He Pandeham Shri Guru Shri Upatalam Shri Guru Shri Vaishnavacham Shri Upam Sagrajatam Sahagadagunat Vitam Sadhimam Sādvaitam Sāvadhūtam Parijan Saita Krishna Chaitanya Deva Shri Rādhā Krishna Pādāna Sahagana Lalitā Shri Viśākhāvitamsa He Krishna Karunā Sindho Dīna Bandho Jagatpate Gopeshya Gopika Kāntam Radha Kāntam Namaste Tapte Kāñcan Gaurangi Shri Rādhe Vindrā Pareshwari Vishwanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Devacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namo Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Sambhashadi Gaur Bhakta Vinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Today I am happy and grateful for this opportunity to serve all of you. Hare Krishna. So this is chapter 7, the knowledge of the absolute. So today I am going to discuss about three modes of material nature. But before going to discuss these three modes of nature, I will tell you a little bit about this three middle session. We are in middle session Bhagavad Gita. So at the conclusion of chapter 6, Dhyana Yoga, Krishna declared that who thinks of me within himself, renders loving transcendental service to me and great faith in me. He is the best of all yogis, amongst all yogis in me. So this is my opinion. And here the sixth chapter is finished. Now we are in middle of sixth chapter. So in Bhagavad Gita, this last verse is the yogi naam api sarvesa amad gati nanta atmana sraddhavan bhajte yomam so manjutta samamata. This is the last verse of sixth chapter, Dhyan Yoga. So in Bhagavad Gita, there are 18 chapters. Everybody knows. So first six chapters, Krishna describe about Karma Yoga or Sankhya Yoga. And middle six chapters about Bhakti Yoga. And last six chapters, he describes about Atma Samarpan or surrender to Lord. So here middle of six chapters, like 7 to 12, the middle of the six chapters, essence of the Bhagavad Gita. The sixth first chapter and last six chapters are covering, you know, like middle of six chapter. And our Acharya also says this middle six chapters are the cream of Bhagavad Gita. Like, you know, cream biscuits, everybody know, you know, everybody likes also cream biscuit. So here is like, how does it look like cream biscuit? Here is one layer of flour, or here is one layer of flour. So here is first six chapter, or here is last six chapter. And middle is cream, but not simple like, or simple cream. This is sweet cream, you know. So our Acharya compare this middle six chapter with cream, sweet cream. So here is six chapter, first and last chapter, and middle is the sweet cream. So essence of the Bhagavad Gita. So in middle six chapter are Bhakti Yoga. So and very, very important. This chapter are very, very important also. And this six chapter, Krishna protected also. This six chapter, middle six chapter. So I want to say something about what Prabhupada said about Bhakti, you know. In Prabhupada said one of his purpose that when Karma Yoga increase in knowledge and renunciation, the stage is called Jnana Yoga. When Jnana Yoga increase in meditation on the Supreme Lord by different physical process, the stage is called Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga means Eight Folds Yoga. Everybody knows Eight Folds Yoga's names. Yam. First when we have to do yoga, you know, first yam, niyam, then asana, then pranayam, then pratyahara, then dharana, then dhyana, and last stage is samadhi. Some people do then yoga, then last stage samadhi, they always sleep, like fall asleep. The last stage is the samadhi. So in the Bhagavad Gita, so Prabhupada explained the dhyana yoga, merge in Ashtanga Yoga. And when one comes to the Supreme Personality Godhead, that it is called this Bhakti Yoga. So the highest point of all kind of yoga lies in Bhakti Yoga. So Karma Yoga or merge. Karma Yoga merge in Jnana Yoga, Jnana Yoga merge in Ashtanga Yoga or Dhyana Yoga, and Dhyana Yoga merge in Bhakti Yoga. So Bhakti Yoga is the top most, you know, like lower step is Karma Yoga, then Jnana Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, and the topmost is the Bhakti Yoga. So in this chapter, Krishna explained about his personal appearance, like his all beauties, knowledge, fame, strange. In the second verse, he explained about his knowledge. And here is he explained about in Bal, you know, Bal Balvatamaham. So strange, beauty. He's here. He explains about all this to Arjuna. Now, there comes to the point, this verse. This verse says, Tri Guna Maye Bhave. Means, these three modes of material nature, Sarvam Idam Jagat, Mohitam Nabi Janati, Mame Bhavarma Mamo. So Krishna says, deluded by the three modes of material nature, rudeness, passion, and ignorance, the whole world does not mean. Who am above these all modes of nature? They does not know me. So here Krishna explained about three modes of nature: goodness, sattva guna, patience, raja, and ignorance, tamangana. So the Vishnu is the mode of goodness. Brahmaji is the mode of patience. And last one, Shiva is the mode of ignorance. So here I would say the Vishnu is maintainer, Brahmaji is creator, and Shiva is destroyer. So in Bhagavatam, canto 4, chapter 3, verse number 23, Shivji says to Parvati, Satvam Visudham Vasudev Satitam. Krishna says to Parvati, I always engage in offering obeisance to Vasudev Krishna. He is pure Krishna consciousness. So Krishna consciousness is the always pure Krishna consciousness. He is the Supreme Personality, is known as Vasudeva, and revealed without any covering. So Krishna is above three modes, three guna. So therefore he is Nirguna. So name is, Krishna's name is Nirguna, because these three modes does not affect him. That's why he is Nirguna. And the Vedas also mainly says that with the subject of the three modes of nature. So according to the three modes of nature, our vision is covered, so we cannot see the Krishna. According to three modes of nature, our vision is covered, so we do not see the Krishna. And living entity also does not know what that behind the material nature, material energy, there is a Supreme Personality of God or Godhead. And the whole world divided or confused also, that the material, the behind the material world nature, there is a Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. So one more verse is here in this Bhagavad Gita chapter 14, the whole chapter is the three modes of material nature. Anybody knows? This in Bhagavad Gita, this chapter number 14, the whole chapter Krishna explained about these three modes of nature. So here Krishna says to Sattvam Raja Tama Iti Guna Prakruti Sambhava Nibandanti Mahabaho Dehi Dehinam Abhiram. What Krishna said, O Arjuna, this material nature passes the three modes of goodness, patience, and ignorance. When the eternal living entities comes in the nature, so they become conditioned by this three mode of material nature. So the mode of goodness condition one to happiness. And the ignorance condition one to fruitive activity, and ignorance covering one's knowledge and bind to then madness. So this I am going to say that this satogun थोड़ा हिंदी में बताऊंगी. तो सतोगुण जब कोई सतोगुण में होता है तो हैप्पी होता है, हैप्पीनेस होता है उसको. सतोगुण हमेशा उसको सत्व से सुख से बांधता है, और तमो रजोगुण होता है वो सकाम कर्म से बांधता है, और जब कोई तमोगुण में होता है तो उसको पागलपन और अंधकार उससे बांधता है. सो इन कृष्णा ऑल्सो वन मोर इन चैप्टर टू इन दिस भगवद गीता Krishna explained about Arjuna, the three guna vishaya veda. Nishtre guna bhav Arjuna, nirdanda nitya sattvastha niryoga kshematvan. So Krishna says, this, you go beyond these three modes of nature. Because this three mode of nature is like bound to everyone. So you go raise himself beyond these three modes of nature. So in Bhagavatam also, chapter canto 11, chapter 25th, Krishna explained these three modes of nature to Uddhava. Same about all three modes of nature. And in Bhagavatam chapter 4 also, Narad Muni explained to Parchin by his sons Prachetagan. This same thing, three modes of material nature. So in this part, in this first part also, Srila Prabhupada explained this. Those who are purely in goodness, They are called Brahmana, those who are purely in the mood of patience, they are Kshatriya. Those who are pure in ignorance, both ignorance and patience, they are called Sudra. They are just Kshatru, Vaishya. And those who are completely in ignorance, they are called Sudra. And above this, then they are less than that, they are animals. So, Prabhupada also explains all three, they are three functions of all three, four class of main functions in the mode of material nature. And in our, you know, then our, how many Puranas do we have? How many Puranas do we have? 18 Puranas. So this 18 Purana also divided into three modes of material nature. And this Vedas Prabhu also explained one time this. According to our Puranas, the three divided into three, Sattva, Raja and Tama, goodness, patience and ignorance. So Vedas Prabhu also explained, but I am going to explain again, he already knows. The goodness Puranas are Vishnu Puran, Bhagavad Puran, Narada Puran, Garuda Puran, Padma Puran and Varaha Puran. This is Sattva Guna, this is goodness Purana. And patience Puranas are Rajaguni Puranas are Brahman Puran, Brahma Vaivartan Puran, Markandeya Puran, Bhavishya Puran, Vaman Puran and Brahma Puran. And ignorance Puranas are Tamaguni Puranas, Matsya Puran, Purma Puran, Linga Puran, Siv Puran, Skanda Puran and Agni Purans. So our Acharya says we don't have to read this Tamaguni, like ignorance person. But if you have time, you can read. But you can read only Bhagavad Gita is enough. All essence is, everything is here in Bhagavad Gita, like all Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads, everything in one book in Bhagavad Gita. So we don't have time in this material, in this Kali Yuga, we don't have time to see. We just read Bhagavad Gita. Don't have time. Just one verse every day. Anybody reads every day Bhagavad Gita?
I read, sir.
We have to try it. We have 24 hours a day, right? So you have to take it up only 5 minutes. It takes only 5 minutes. If you are unable to read this Sanskrit, so you can read just translation. Then start from one first chapter and one word, first word, text one. Then you can read every day one, then you can understand also. So in Bhagavad Gita, I have to ask, Krishna explained one word so many times in Bhagavad Gita. Anybody knows? I'm sorry? Just one word he explained so many times in Bhagavad Gita. In this chapter, 14 times. Anybody knows? Those who read this verse in Sanskrit, they can understand. Mam word. In this chapter, 14 times, when you read this verse every day, then you can understand so many times. Mom, whatever you do, next this verse, Devi Sarvaguna Mimama Maya Duratya, Mom, Eva Prabhadande, Maya Metam Tarandite, Manamana Bhava Madhya Bhakta Madhyati, Mom Namaskaru, Anyanya Cheta, Yo Mom Smarati Nityasya, Tasya Aham Napranash, Tasya Nam Pranashati Sachimen, Sarva Dharman Paritaja, Mamekam Sarnam Vaja, Bahunam Janmanande, Gyanvan, Man Prabhadande. Then there's so many are there. So we have so many times he used this Mam word. So every day we experience sun sign, moon sign, they all are the Krishna. There will be see everywhere and anywhere great thing that is also Krishna. Krishna is the best. Krishna is the best origin. Krishna is the essence of everything. So everything is Krishna. So here, this middle sixth chapter, Krishna explained about all bhakti yoga to Arjuna. Now Brahmaji also said about to Krishna. In Brahma Sahita, Ishwarahi Paramahi Krishna, Sat Chit Ananda Vigraha, Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarvata Anandana. In Bhagavatam also, somewhere I have read, Krishna Tu Swayam Bhagavan. So, Krishna is everything. Krishna is the all essence of the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is everything of essence of everything. Krishna is the best. So we all love, we every day come to temple. We every day do some service also. We do attend all classes Sunday. So do you think Krishna love us or Krishna like us? Sometimes we do something, I do for this Krishna today, I do this seva. But still Krishna like or dislike? Like? How do you know?
Do this.
But this answer also in Bhagavad Gita. Everybody knows where it is? In chapter 12. There is the smallest chapter, this 12 and number 15. There is only 20 verses. So number from 13 to 20. In 8 verses, Krishna explained this. Ki kaunsa bhakta Krishna ko priya hai. So number 13 is, all Vesta, I know just good. All Vesta Sarva Bhutana, Maitriya Karma Yavacha, Nirmama Nirantara Sama, Dukha Sukha Sami, Santosta Sadatam Yogi, Yat Atma Margistya, Mai Arpit Maravani, Mada Bhakta Sami Priya. So whenever you get time, go home, if you have Bhagavad Gita, read this 8, then you will realize the Krishna like or dislike. When you get time, then please read these 8 verses. Krishna says to Arjuna, what kind of bhakta I like, you know. So this is the question, Krishna like or dislike. So here, in this Kali Yuga, we don't have to read all this Purana, if you don't have time, Bhagavad Gita, so please don't read. But in Kali Yuga, there is simple, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave us a Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. In Sukhdev Goswami also says to Parikshit Maharaj, you know, in the Bhagavatam 12th canto, Purteyata Dhyaya Dhyayata Vishnu, Tetayam Yajat Mukhe, Dvapare Parichayana, Kalotata Hari Kirtana. In Satyunga, we achieve to Krishna, we have to do tapasya many, many years. Then we will achieve the Krishna. And Treta Yuga, we have they do yagya. And in Treta Yuga, they do worship. In the Dwapara Yuga, they do deity worshiping. And in Kali Yuga, Kirtan, Hari Nam Kirtan, say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And next verse also say Kale Dos Nidhe Rajan. Kale Dos Nidhe Rajan, Asti Hi Ek Mahan Guna. Krishnanatya Krishna Sha Mukta Sandho Paramgaje. In Kali Yuga, lots of faults, ocean of faults, but there is one good quality also in Kali Yuga, and that quality is Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So in Kali Yuga, we don't have to do anything, just chant and be happy. So this is the easiest way to achieve the Krishna. So we have to chant every day. If you not get time, just chant one round. This is the, you know, for this Kali Yuga, just chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So, I don't have to so much to say, but there is three verses. I have three verses to we pray to Krishna. So I will tell you that. Please repeat me. Ishvara hi parama hi Krishna.
Ishvara hi parama.
Satchidananda Vigraha,
Anadi
Radhi Govinda,
Sarvakarana
Karanam,
Om
Purnamadam,
Purnamidam,
Purnat
Purnamuchyate,
Purnasya Purnamadayam,
Purnameva
Vasishyate.
Krishnaya
Vasudevaya,
Devaki
Nanda
Nandaya
cha,
Nanda Gopa
Kumaraya,
Govindaya
Namo
Namo,
Whenever we do prayer at home or wherever we have to chant this prayer verses, so Krishna also happy and we also happy. So today I am going to stop here because I don't have to say much. So if you have any, regarding this class, if you have any question or if you want to give me some suggestion, can you? No? Okay, Hare Krishna. Yes. I'm going to stop here. And please, if I did some mistakes, so please forgive me and give me blessing. So next time, whenever I will get a chance to say something about Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.